game. Champions in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, in a match made last week by our guest host, the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase. Triple H, along with John Cena, will challenge Randy Orton for the WWE title in a triple threat match.
Somewhere in this arena, Randy Orton is watching this, and so is John Cena.
All right, let me catch you up to speed in case you've been living under a rock for the last month. About a month ago, Donald Trump bought Monday Night Raw. But 7 days later, Vince McMahon bought it back. For double the price, but whatever, you know. In the meantime, something very exciting happened. It's a thing called the celebrity guest host. Well, it's my job tonight to introduce tonight's guest host. He's a star of television and film. You might recognize him from such things as Buffy the Vampire Slayer or Austin Powers. He's also in The Family Guy, and he's a co-creator of his own show, Robot Chicken.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, my friend, Seth Green.
All right. Tonight's special guest host of Monday Night Raw. This guy's great. You know, Donald Trump did own Raw for all of a week, but he did make some changes like this one, having a guest host instead of a general manager. And you know what that means for the guest host?
I've heard about America's Own Dreamin'.
Hey, you know, Seth Green is going to be the guest host tonight, and along with that job goes, well, as Mr. Trump put it, unlimited power. I mean, he can do anything he wants to here tonight on Raw. He's running the show. Running around the ring as well. Be careful, be careful. Don't hurt yourself, Seth. Whoa, hey, Seth got some moves.
Seth Green.
He's a big guy, isn't he? Triple H sucks taller than him.
He's amazing, guys. He's amazing. I am thrilled beyond imagination to be hosting WWE Monday Night Raw! I wanted to do some exciting stuff tonight. I mean, I get the opportunity to do anything I want. I can program matches however I want. So I thought the first thing I would do, something really exciting. Maybe a six-person Diva Swimsuit Summer Spectacular?
Oh!
Like that?
I like that.
You guys be into that?
Mm-hmm.
I think it would. I mean, it's, you know, it's in the interest of the spirit of athletic competition. I want to make sure that people see.
No, of course, it's all about the athleticism. Why else on Raw would we have six scantily clad girls rolling around together?
Yeah,
I mean, it's totally an athletic event.
I'm glad you see it that way.
Right, yeah, no.
I'm pretty excited about
it. This is great. You know what, Seth? And this is the kind of outside-the-box thinking that makes me such a huge fan of Robot Chicken.
Oh, thanks.
They take big celebrities and they put them in the craziest, most outrageous situations. And the thing is, now you're getting, like, the biggest celebrities on the planet are just clamoring to be in this thing. It's so popular.
It's amazing.
But take, for example, this episode you have, the premiere episode on July 26th. It's got probably the biggest star in the world on it. I mean, this guy, he's probably the most recognizable person on the planet.
Yeah, definitely. It was a huge get for us, and would the people like to see a clip from the season premiere?
Yes, yes.
Awesome. Well, I brought you a clip, so check this out.
John Cena was supposed to challenge me for this championship tonight, but apparently he got lost on his way here.
That is a load of bull. We saw Triple H let the air out of John Cena's tires. Damn him.
I guess if nobody's man enough to challenge me, I'll just take my championship belt and go home.
It's her! It's her! Dakota Fanning is in the building, and man, she looks beautiful!
And let's not forget that Dakota's new movie, Wish Magic, The Horse That Wrote Poems, opens Friday in theaters across the country.
I thought I was here to talk about Wish Magic, The Horse That Wrote Poems, but apparently some son of a had to go and run his mouth.
This match is over if she can pin him in the ring. It's John Cena.
He must want a piece of Triple H, too.
Oh! It's a damn double cross. John Cena.
Oh, man.
That was a recreation. She didn't actually do that to me.
Thanks. Thanks for doing that, man. That was awesome to get you in there. And I remember you said that you had some experience fighting whiny little girls ever since your first match with Randy Orton.
Ooh.
Is that what you said?
Now, Seth, trying to be funny, I didn't actually call Randy Orton a whiny little girl, even though he is actually a whiny little girl. The thing is, I actually have all the respect in the world for both Randy Orton and Dakota Fanning because actually they have something in common. Neither one of them have male genitalia.
Whoa.
So, you know, they got that going.
Oh, there is the WWE champion.
And it looks like he didn't get the joke.
Now, the personal animosity between Triple H and Randy Orton, very well documented. In fact, it gets to the next level as 2 weeks tonight of Champions came, and Orton and Triple H along with John Cena will battle it out for the championship.
You know what? If I were Seth Green right now, even though they're standing next to Triple H, I might want to consider getting out of the ring.
Randy Orton has never won for his sense of humor.